first guest is really a winner. I mean, seriously, she is so cool. She is both a Northwestern cheerleader and a competitive bodybuilder. Please give it up for Lee Healy. First of all, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
How are you?
Doing well.
Okay,
yeah.
Great. It's my understanding you competed last weekend at Nationals, right? And finished in the top 10. You want to go into a little bit about what that is?
Yeah, so I competed in 3 shows the past 3 weekends. 2 were at the local level, and then I qualified for Nationals, and the first national show this year was in Charleston, South Carolina. So I went to compete there last weekend. I qualified for that show during my first season when I competed in October.
That's amazing. But take me back to the beginning of this whole like bodybuilding, because it's, you know, it's not a conventional thing to become a part of. So how did you get to know bodybuilding, become a part of that?
So I actually started my fitness journey really being super into running. I convinced myself that I really liked running. Ran a half marathon freshman year, and really spent like every single day in the gym running for like at least an hour a day, and then realized I actually hated that a lot. I actually also was in a really crappy relationship at the time, so I really kind of wanted to, like, I don't know. So that was also going on in my life. And one day I was scrolling on Instagram with one of my friends, and we came across a page of a girl that I went to high school with. And I was like, wow, she like looks really good. I want to look like her. And so I clicked on her Instagram page, and everyone that she was following on Instagram, I was like, what are they doing? Like, what is this? And then I realized that they all competed in bikini. And I said, you know what, like, I'm gonna do that one day. So I immediately went back to my dorm room, set up an account on bodybuilding.com, and then also immediately drove to GNC and got all the protein powder I thought I needed. And and I started lifting, and then decided in April of that year that I wanted to start competition preparation right away. As I said, I was in like a really bad place. Not only was I in a like crappy relationship, but I also was going through a really hard time with binge eating. And I decided that that would be the best move for me to just do it right then, show myself that I could do it. It all went from there.
Dude, that's amazing. That's so cool. Sound like so effortless, but like the work that you put in must be pretty grueling. I mean, what kind of work do you have to do for it?
Well, for this past contest preparation, I definitely feel like I lived in the gym. It's a lot of early morning cardio sessions followed by later going back to the gym to lift and do more cardio. I would have to practice posing after all that in the gym. I would get a lot of weird looks from people when I'm wearing high heels at the gym, not really a thing. But more than anything, it's a lot of exactly measuring out your chicken and Brussels sprout portions.
I totally know where the gym is and eat Brussels sprouts. That must take up a lot of time. You said early mornings, I think you said 6 a.m. at one point. Like, but so, I mean, balancing that, and you're also a cheerleader for Northwestern. So how do you, like, I mean, is there ever conflict there? And how do you balance those two things?
Yeah, well, even like when I first did it and competed in October, it was really hard balancing with football season and like game day and everything and with our practices. And then going into this year, it was really hard to balance with our practices. And then also, too, I don't know if everyone knows, but we went to March Madness this year.
Did you know that? Okay.
Yeah, so before that week, we also went to the Men's Big Ten tournament in Washington, D.C., and then the following week, we were in Salt Lake City for that. And so I had to travel that whole time while I was on contest preparation, so I had to bring a little lunchbox filled with all of my meal prep food, and a mini fridge can only hold so much in a hotel room. So I would also go to the grocery stores while we were there, and also had to fit in all my training with the hotel gyms and like try to like balance everything, because also too, you don't really like when we're on those trips, we don't ever really like know what we're doing. They kind of just like tell us like right before. And so for like a lot of the appearances, I didn't really know like when I would be able to eat and like when I could like work out, and like I have to eat like around like certain times, so it would be like kind of hard to balance everything. But it all works out in the end, and it kind of makes then more worth it knowing that you did all of those things along the way.
And I mean, but even traveling for bodybuilding, there have to be like things like that. I mean, do you run into any struggles like that at competitions or like when you're traveling for that?
Definitely traveling can be really hard. Even with nationals, I know that a lot of people told me to shy away from traveling the day before, which I had to do because of classes, because it like leads to water retention. And also like with that too, like traveling was really hard because leading up to the show, we'd have to drink like a ridiculous amount of water, which was also really hard with classes because I was peeing like literally every 2 seconds. And my teachers like never really like understood why. So it was kind of weird having to explain that.
Teachers never understand. So in terms of, didn't you say there was like a thing about peeing at the competitions that was like?
Also along the same note, peeing. So there's actually a special way that female bodybuilders have to go to the bathroom at shows. So I don't know if anyone knows, but we get really, really, really dark tans for our shows. And these are a special kind of tan. They're not like any regular spray tan. You get like 5 layers more, and like no liquid can touch it whatsoever, like at all. So you actually have to pee through a styrofoam cup.
Been there.
So it's like really like hard to get used to at first, and I didn't really know that as well, and I didn't know there's a special like technique behind it. There's definitely different techniques to be used. At my first show, actually, when I got the spray tan, I had a certain amount of water I had to drink. I downed it right before because I had to finish it at a certain time. So then by the time I finished getting my tan and I got back to my hotel room, I like really had to pee. But I hadn't practiced the like technique yet. So I didn't really like know what to do. So I went to go to the bathroom and then realized I like decided not to punch out at the bottom of the cup, which is like an optional like thing you can do. So I realized that I had to pee a lot more than I realized. Panicked, you know, like, oh my god, like, what am I supposed to do? Do I, like, keep, like, I don't know, do I drop the cup? But then, like, if I drop it, then I'm still peeing. So I decided to just stand up. And then I dropped the cup on me. And so then, obviously, like, my entire tan is, like, ruined. And then I started to cry, but then I couldn't cry because of my face. It's funny now.
I imagine in the moment it was much, less good attitude about it. But I mean, even with like that kind of stuff you have to be so particular about, and like the amount of work that goes into it, you still keep such a good attitude about it. And like, there's this community you talk about for me, but like, why do you love it? You know, what do you take away from this that you love it and you keep coming back?
Yeah, I really just all the people that I've met through it really just make it so amazing. Being able to bond with everyone, like knowing that everyone has gone through all of those same struggles, learning how to pee, but also like knowing that like each and every day, all of you have weighed out your food, measured it exactly, eaten at random times of the day, and then also like gone to the gym, like lived there, like this passion, the drive, the dedication, knowing that you all did that together. And also too, like at my first show, I didn't really like understand that because it had just been such an individual journey. And I remember when I was talking to someone I had met at the show, and he was telling me about one of his past shows, and he was like, yeah, I placed second, like blah blah blah, and we were just like talking about the placings, and I was like, oh, well, like, you know, I was just like commenting on the placings, and he said, you know, we're all winners here. because we all did this journey together. We all did this, worked so hard. And I was like, you know, like, that's so true. Like, we all are winners. And just ever since, like, I heard that, knowing that we all worked so hard together makes it such a close community.
Totally. Yeah, that's awesome. That's awesome.